In this brief video, we discuss cost volume profit analysis with examples. That is, how the cost of production and volume or quantity relate to profit. In particular, we discuss the special case where no profit or loss is made, which we refer to as breakeven. The breakeven point refers to the minimum quantity of a product to sell without generating a loss, or how much sales are required before a business starts making profit. So at breakeven point, total revenue equals total cost. In theory, total cost is divided mainly into fixed costs and variable costs. Fixed costs are assumed to remain the same, irrespective of the volume of production, over a period of time. Examples are rent, property tax, and insurance. It does not matter the quantity of output, these fixed costs remain the same. Variable costs, on the other hand, changes as the volume of output changes. They are directly proportional to the level of activity or volume of production. That is, the more the units of output, the higher the total variable cost. If the variable cost per unit of an item is $3, and 10 units of that item is produced, then the total variable cost will be 3 times 10, that is $30. That is, total variable cost equals variable cost per unit times the number of units produced, which we denote as X. Examples of variable costs are cost of materials, shipping costs, and credit card fees. These costs increase with increases in output. We can now put the formula for total cost as the sum of fixed cost and total variable cost. Now, total revenue is selling price per unit times the number of items sold. Note that selling price per unit is sometimes denoted simply as S or P, and the number of units as Q. Another important concept in cost volume profit analysis is the contribution margin per unit. This is simply the amount by which the selling price per unit exceeds the variable cost per unit. So if a smartwatch that sells for $60 has a variable cost of $20, the contribution margin per unit is simply 60 minus 20, which is $40. Now at breakeven point, total revenue equals total cost. That is, selling price per unit times the number of units equals fixed cost plus variable cost times the number of units. On solving for X, we have a formula for breakeven in units, which is simply fixed cost divided by the contribution margin per unit. Finally, we have the contribution rate or ratio, which expresses the contribution margin as a ratio or percentage of the selling price. We can use it to determine the breakeven dollars, that is, the total cost or total revenue at breakeven. And that can be determined by dividing the fixed cost by the contribution ratio. Now let's look at some examples. Here we want to determine the breakeven point in units and in dollars. Note that there are two variable costs here, production cost and selling cost. We first combine them, so we have a total variable cost function of 15x. The total cost function is therefore 4000, the fixed cost, plus 15x, the total variable cost. From the selling price per unit of $40, we have the total revenue function of 40x. To find the breakeven unit, we can solve for x in the total revenue equals total cost equation, or simply divide the fixed cost by the unit's contribution margin, and that gives 160 units. So in order to break even, we must produce 160 units. We can then find the breakeven point in dollars by substituting the breakeven units of 160 into either the total cost function or the total revenue function, and that would give 6,400. Now, suppose this business has a capacity to produce only 500 units. Then we can calculate the breakeven point as a percent of capacity by simply dividing the breakeven point in units by the capacity units. And that would give 32%. In essence, we need to reach 32% of capacity before breaking even. In the next example, we'll solve a profit-related problem. A manufacturer has the capacity to produce 500 units of their product per month. Selling price is $85 per unit, and that makes the total revenue function 85x. Variable costs are $30 per unit, and fixed costs are $68.75. Thus, the total cost is $68.75 plus 30x. Now, what we're calling profit here is actually net income or operating profit. That is, revenue minus total cost before deducting other expenses. So, if 100 units are sold, total revenue will be $8,500 and total cost will be $98.75. Since total cost is greater than total revenue, operating profit will actually be a loss of $13.75. In number 2, to realize the maximum profit, the manufacturer has to sell all 500 units they are capable of producing. So, total revenue will be $42,500 and total cost will be $21,875, giving a maximum profit of $26,25. Next, we want to calculate the number of units to be sold to realize a profit of $9,800. In other words, total revenue minus total cost equals $9,800. And on subtracting and solving for X, we obtain 303.18, which we have to round up to 304 because we can't sell fractions of a unit, and we have to round up to the next integer because selling 303 units will generate slightly less than the required profit. Note that we can also calculate the number of units directly by dividing fixed cost plus profit by the unit contribution margin. And that's it. In the next video, I'll be solving a problem involving the breakeven chart. Thanks for watching.